everyone, and welcome back to the YouTube channel. Today we're in beautiful, beautiful New York City. I've actually never been to New York in the summertime, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. It's also kind of loud. We're actually here for Gary V's podcast, and you guys have either seen that video already. Yes, you have. You've seen that video already, so we're also just in the middle of the city filming some stuff, and I wanted to talk to you guys about something today. I wrote about it on my Instagram caption, and it really resonated with so many people. I got a ton of comments about it, and it really, really resonated because it's something that I think a lot of us think about in the back of our minds all the time, but we don't really verbalize and understand that it's okay to think this way. So when I was 19, like we all are, we get told to pick a major in college. And I didn't know a whole lot about myself when I was 19. Like, I did not have a whole lot of life experiences. You guys know, like, my childhood was pretty good. Like, I didn't have anything crazy happen to me as a child, and I didn't really have a whole lot of experiences to teach me things about myself. All I really knew was that I wanted to help people. I was pretty smart in school, and all of my friends came to me with their problems all the time. And I was just like the good listener friend, the friend that was giving advice to other friends and helping them out in life and stuff like that. My thought process, and a lot of people's thought processes when they're picking a major and what they're gonna do for literally the rest of their lives. We go to college and we pick a major, and that's our plan for the next 30, 40, 50 years to do forever, right? Crazy as a 19-year-old to tell 18, 19-year-olds, hey, go pick your major in college, you're gonna do this for the rest of your life and you're gonna spend $100,000 and go into debt for it. Hope you pick the right thing. So many college kids are in debt, and so many adults are in a life that isn't happy and a job that doesn't make them happy because they were told to pick something as a kid and they felt like they have to be married to that and do it for the rest of their lives. So like I said, that's all I knew about myself. I went through college. I still thought that nursing was a great career for me, so my thought process was it pays pretty well, it's really respectable, it'll probably be around forever, and it was just, it made sense logically, not soulfully or passionately. It made sense logically, but it didn't feel connected. Like, these two were not connected with nursing. It just wasn't. So when I started to do fitness coaching and online stuff and the social media thing, it felt really connected in here. It felt really, really, really connected in here. And I was so excited about learning and all the logical things and how people's bodies actually changed and how my body actually changed. But I felt so passionate about serving someone else and saying, here's this. This is why I do what I do, and here's how it's gonna help you. And then they came back to me and said, oh my goodness, I completely resonate with that. It really changed my life. It changed my thought process around binge eating, around training, around food, around anything. And the thing is, we don't really know what we're gonna be doing for the rest of our lives until we start doing things that make us feel a certain way. I had no clue I was gonna be on social media. I had no clue I was gonna be public speaking, talking to a camera all the time. Those were things that I naturally and safely felt like weren't for me when I was a kid. And then I started doing them and experiencing them, and it made me feel so good. Like, I just felt in my soul that it was what I was meant to do. And I started to gather information about myself through doing that. So maybe you're in a cubicle right now. Maybe you are doing a certain job. Maybe you're driving Uber. Maybe you're, I don't know what you're doing. Whatever you're doing right now, maybe it's making you feel a certain way. And maybe that feeling is amazing, and maybe it's not so amazing. Maybe it makes you feel like dreadful walking into work. Maybe it makes you feel like you are living for the weekends. Maybe it makes you feel excited, but not all the way excited, like I was with nursing, but not like all the way there. And guess what? That is so available for you. We don't know what we're gonna be doing for the rest of our lives. We get to learn it on the way. Like, we get to experience life and learn what we're gonna be doing for the rest of our lives. I think our society and the way that we train kids to go to college, it shows us you get to pick one thing forever, and then you get retirement, and then like you fall in line with how the government works and all that stuff. And that's great for a lot of people, but it doesn't work for everybody. And it didn't work for me. It just did not make me feel like so passionate and happy about my life. What makes me happy is learning about myself, experiencing something, learning more about myself and saying, maybe I want to pivot and go do this. So when I went from fitness to entrepreneurship, I was evolving so much, and I felt so passionate in my soul about what I was learning. Because I am such a person that I've learned this about myself, I need to verbalize things to really learn them and to really feel into them and to really like get so excited about them. And that's why I have a YouTube channel, that's why I have a podcast, that's why I have Instagram, that's why I'm like constantly teaching you guys things, because I need that. Like, I need to get it out there. And I know that about myself now. And without that, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing. So when I was learning about business and entrepreneurship and mindset shifts and paradigm shifts and all these things, that I just felt so excited to share them with everybody that I just had to, regardless of if it fit in my little fitness box that I was in or not, which is why there's so much tension with the pivot of what I'm doing. But it's okay for me, because it feels so good. And the change is something that actually, it is scary for a lot of people because it's not natural. So if you are in a job right now that you don't want to be in, it's okay to go do something else. It's terrifying because we spent so much money on our college degrees and we're in all this debt, and that's why it's important to actually go learn the practical tactical from other people who are doing what you want to be doing. The fastest way to learn something and to do something is to hire someone who's done what you want to do and go learn from them and then do the same thing. But if something is making you feel amazing, like if what I'm doing is making you feel so excited right now and you're like, I could do that, or that makes me excited, that might mean that it's time to make a little pivot. But I know it's terrifying because you've spent so much, you're so committed, you were so all in, and you do have to go all in. You have to go all in with every single thing that you do in your life. Maybe you spend 2 years going all in with college. Maybe you spend 4 years going all in with YouTube. Maybe you spend 5 years going all in writing a book and doing a being speaker and doing all these things. And I went all in with fitness YouTube and vlogging and prepping. And now I'm going all in with my business stuff and creating a team and building an empire and making sure that all of the stuff that's going on in my head is being transferred to here so you guys can experience it with me, right? So you have to go all in, but you don't have to go all in with just one thing for the rest of your life. I've never been excited about the word niche. Like, everyone tells you, make sure you pick a niche, make sure that you're really focused, really clear. And I know it's terrifying for so many people to say, I only want to coach women who want to lose their first 5 pounds, or I only want to coach women to get stronger and to do squats and deadlifts and bench press and be powerlifting. Because what if you don't want to do that in the next 2 years? It's scary to say that. And I think the thing is, yes, you do have to go all in on one thing, but you don't have to go all in on that one thing forever and ever and ever. Going all in on something is so important and valuable because it teaches you so many different skill sets that you need to experience to learn things about yourself so you can get more and more and more clear about your why, about your mission, about your vision for your life, about your vision for the world, about why you were put on this earth, about your gifts, about your talents. You don't get to learn about that stuff until you try them. I had to experience a lot of stuff before I was able to get to this point. So I just wanna let you guys know that's available for you too. If you're in a job right now, you don't have to stay there forever. If you pick one thing and you jump from your job to entrepreneurship and you're trying to niche down, you don't have to stick with that one niche forever, but you do have to go all in. You do have to try to experience things because that's how you're going to learn. Life is not meant to be just you pick something and then you just have a shitty life for the rest of your life just because you picked that thing when you were a teenager. You can pick something when you're a teenager. You can pick something when you're in your early 20s, in your late 20s, in your early 30s, in your late 30s, your 40s, 50s, 60s. Like, you can pick new things all the time. And that's what makes life so awesome and exciting, because you get to do that. We all get to do that. And we don't have to stay stuck forever. So I hope this message resonates with you. Tag someone in the comment section if you're on Facebook. Share the video if you're on Facebook. If you're on YouTube, give the video a thumbs up. Comment below. I want to hear your thoughts about this because I know it resonated with a lot of people on Instagram. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Woo! Thanks, Chuck.